Suppose you are given a convex set. So for every two points in the set, the line segment connecting the two points is also in the set. And a point which is not in the convex set. Can we always find a line which separates the convex set and the point? So the set is on the one side and the point on the other? For a set which is not convex, like this one, and a point placed here, this is not possible. More generally, consider a real vector space of any dimension. So for example, spaces like Rn. Given a convex set and a point not in the set, is there a hyperplane in X which separates the convex set from the point? A hyperplane is a space with dimension 1 less than the surrounding space. So in dimension 1, a zero-dimensional point is a hyperplane. In 2 dimensions, a line, and in 3 dimensions, a plane. So how do we solve this problem? Although this is a geometric problem, we are going to use analytic methods to solve it. Specifically, we are going to encode the convex set into something called a sublinear functional, and the separating hyperplane into a linear functional. Then the Hahn-Banach theorem gives us the solution. This is a very general theorem, which is for instance very useful in functional analysis. So let's start by describing the line. It's described by an equation of this form. We may use the left side of this equation to define a function from R2 to the real numbers. This function is linear. So the value of the sum of two vectors is the same as the sum of the values, and we can pull out any factors. Then the line consists of all points where this function assumes the value c. More generally, we have that a subset is a hyperplane if it consists of all points where a linear functional assumes a certain value, where linearity is defined like this. So the separating line consists of all points where f is equal to c. The line separates the space in two sections. On the left side, where the convex set is, f is lower or equal to c, and on the other side, it's greater or equal to c. We say that a linear functional separates a set k from a point if f is lower or equal than c on k, and f of the point is greater or equal than c. This just means that the hyperplane induced by the linear functional separates the convex set and the point. A weaker notion than linearity is sublinearity. A function is sublinear if the value of a sum is lower or equal than the sum of the values, and we can pull out any positive factors. This is weaker than linearity, so every linear functional is also sublinear. If we weaken linearity to sublinearity, we can find a functional which separates k from all points outside of k. We just have to assume that a small ball around zero is included in k. We are going to use this sublinear functional to describe the convex set in an analytic setting. Specifically, the sublinear functional can be defined like this. It's called the Minkowski functional of a convex set. Now let's connect these two concepts. We say that a sublinear functional dominates a linear functional if this inequality is satisfied. When we plug in a point in the convex set, we see that this inequality already implies that the convex set is on one side of the hyperplane, induced by the linear functional. We only have to guarantee that the point is on the other side. We can do this by requiring that the value of f at x0 is equal to the value of pk at x0. Since the point is not in the convex set, this is greater or equal to c. So a linear functional which is dominated by pk and has this value at x0 separates k and the point. By linearity, we also know the values of f in the span of x0. So f has to extend the linear functional defined on the span. This linear functional is also dominated by pk. The Hahn-Banach theorem guarantees the existence of the linear functional f, which then provides the hyperplane separating the convex set and the point. The general setting looks like this. We are given a real vector space X with a subspace Y, a linear functional on Y, and a sublinear functional on X, which dominates F0. Then there exists a linear extension of F0 to X, which is also dominated by the sublinear functional. In our case, the space Y was one-dimensional. Here it can be any subspace of X. The Hahn-Banach theorem is often used in function analysis to extend continuous linear functionals on normed spaces. Given a normed space and a continuous linear functional, we can extend this functional on the whole space without changing the norm of the functional. Geometrically, the reciprocal of the norm is the same as the distance of this hyperplane to the origin. So geometrically, the theorem says that we can extend a hyperplane in a subspace to a hyperplane in a larger space without changing the distance of the hyperplane to the origin. For example, a continuous linear functional on R has the single point as a hyperplane. Then we can extend this point to a line in a two-dimensional space without changing the distance to the origin. This corresponds to extending the continuous linear functional on R to a continuous linear functional on R2 without changing the norm. Similarly, you can extend a line in R2 to a plane in R3.